Hello everybody, this is Minecraft Maker. Welcome to Minecraft LAN Party. We're in the Nether here. And that probably looks familiar. This is the Nether Fortress Wither Farm sort of thing. And I want to show you something. I've been working a little bit. I know I haven't released any videos on the server in a bit. But look at this. Woohoo, beacon! Three beacons, tri-beacon. Over here, we have quad beacons. Woohoo! And then over here, we have tri-beacon. Okay, so what's going on here? Typically, I'd go into the Nether Fortress, and I'd grab a fire resistance potion, and in case any blazes decided to shoot at me, and I'd grab strength 2 potion in case I decided that I needed to mess with the piggies. But sorry about that. Got a little sick of that, and hey dudes. So I decided to change the way I was doing things here. I figured, look, the strength 2 thing, I could get with a beacon effect. And look at that. Hi. So, with my sharpness 5 sword, diamond sword, and a strength 2 effect from a beacon, I can one-shot everything. And so I put in here, let's go into the center section. The whole farm is a little too long for one beacon, so that's why there are 3. A little annoying, but speed 2, strength 2, regeneration, resistance 2, and jump boost. The jump boost is just there, so I have something to combine with to get regeneration. I have an idea for this that I'll show you in a future episode. Oh, hi, I just saw you spawn. Oh, and there's guys down there too. And the cool thing is with the resistance, the little tiny guys here, they can't hit you. They can't do squat. They just hop around like the little tiny slimes. That's pretty funny. And even if you get caught on fire, when you get put out, look, I haven't lost any health. And I think the same goes true with the wither effect. So, hey dude. So, it's much less dangerous in here now. Hey guys. And makes it easier to collect the wither skulls, which you need for the beacons. And I don't have to come in for 8 minutes at a time on the fire resist potion, although I still have a bunch of fire resist potions out in my little waiting area here. So, I can do that if I want. But, let me show you something. Hang on a second, I'll be right back. So, I don't know if you remember from the first time I did a wither battle on screen, I had to go out, I dug a wither hole to do it in, and I went out, it's in the jungle past Vex's place, and it's a little bit of a pain. And I'm like, oh, idiot, just put a portal out there. So I did. So I added this little tiny tunnel over here, gives me a portal. That goes out to the wither fight hall. Hey, dude. And I decided to put some beacons out here. And I built enough, put enough iron blocks out. This is a lot of iron blocks. It's like 5 stacks of iron blocks or something. I put enough to put 6. So I can get all of the status effects. Which is a bit ridiculous, but hey. Why not? So, I kind of redid the hole a little bit here. This is a little dangerous. And I cleaned everything up. And I filled in the little tunnels that the wither was starting to dig. Oh, hello. Missed a block. So I'm kind of working on that. And I've got this house that I'm building out here. with the beacon. So the house has a little bed so I can go to sleep. Will it let me sleep? Yes, it will. All right, how's my armor? Armor's in good shape. Good. So I have some storage out here. I've got some obsidian. And so I'm going and doing this, which I'm not going to subject you to too much of, but I just want to build up. And I'm using obsidian because the wither, of course, the wither can break obsidian, at least the on their initial the initial blast, the wither can break obsidian. And the block breaker heads that shoot out can also break obsidian, but it's harder. So I didn't want this to get too damaged by the wither, should the wither decide to start digging up this far. It might be overkill, and getting this much obsidian is a little bit of a pain, but since I have... These three beacons came from my hobbit hole base. I pulled them up and brought them over here. And I did a wither fight just to test it. Because here I have strength 2 and regen and resistance, which is a good combination for fighting the wither. So really all I need is night vision potions, because that is very handy when the wither starts knocking out torches and stuff. So I want to make this thing taller. I want where the glass is here, my colored glass, to make my multicolored beacon. So I've got red, green, and blue. This is cyan, magenta, and yellow. So I got all the primary colors. It's going to be pretty much done. So I'm going to build up the roof up to that point and make that the roof. So I got a few more layers to go. I may have enough obsidian here. Don't know. So anyway, let's grab some stuff here and let's see if we can, see if we can make another nether star. This wood and hopper and stuff is for something else, which I will show you later. Let's dump it in here just in case. Don't want to get myself killed. So I went into the end and I've been tearing down those obsidian towers that the Ender Dragon uses for the healing crystals. And so I brought a beacon into the end in order to... That should be plenty. I brought a beacon into the end as kind of a workhorse beacon, to help with tearing down those obsidian towers, because they're pretty slow and annoying if you don't. So, one last thing, sorry. If you watched my most recent episode of the Snapshot Tour, you heard me talk about the golden apple change that got made in the Snapshot. I haven't tested it, but I trust everyone telling me that it's true. Who's that? Okay, so here's how I fight the wither. We should be doing okay here. So I'm going to lay out my little tea of soul sand. Put down two of the heads. and get ready. So we got the beacon effects, so we're pretty good. I'm going to do the night vision potion because it gets dark in here if you don't. And then I'm done with the potions. I've got these splash potions just in case, but I've got the regen, so that shouldn't be too bad. And I'm going to do this. And we're going to do this. Okay, I'm getting nervous. Come on, Wither. Do your blow up thing. Oh, where'd he go? See? Okay, he's focused on me, right? Ah, come on, dude. Where are you? I am withered. Okay, time for the golden apple. Oh. There we go. And we have another. Oh, the wither just cleared. And look, I lost nothing. Okay. And we got a lot of cleanup to do, but goodness gracious, he makes a mess. Anyway, that's like the least stressful way I can think of fighting the nether, the wither. And I could probably go take care of those other. Use up the other wither skulls that I have, but I'm not going to right now. But as I was saying, let's put down some torches because I have night vision right now, but it will get dark. The golden apple makes that a little easier. The enchanted golden apple makes that easier. Just because I'm basically invincible for about 20 seconds. And it makes it a little bit more stress-free. I've got, as you saw there, I've got three quad beacons. So that's 12 beacons out there. I've got three upstairs here. And I have my utility beacon. So so that'll be 12, this is going to be 6 up here, so 18, I've, 19, it's going to be 20-ish beacons when I get done, and that's, oh wait, no, and I've got the four out at the aqua base, so yeah, I've got a lot of beacons. I've killed the wither multiple times, and I've gotten pretty comfortable doing it. I don't think I need the it doesn't need to be a super challenge for me each time, because I'm trying to make beacons, and if there was an easier way of doing it, I would do it that way. But I can take advantage of the resources that I have in order to make it easier for me to fight the wither and get the beacons, get the nether stars that I need to make beacons. And I don't think that needs to be balanced out of the game, but I'm done ranting about that. Why do I have that out? And I didn't need to bring all these in. Anyway, that's that. I'm of course going to run out of blocks here, because the wither always ends up destroying plenty. Oh, he made a hash of this. Okay. But that's fine. So, I've got... which way is it? It's down this way. I'll clean this up later. This isn't super critical to get done now. I just need to make it so that nothing can spawn down here. So I can go make another beacon. I have the nether star. So this is kind of what I've been working on, and making life easier in the nether, in the nether fortress. Beacons are our friends. But of course it requires an awful lot of blocks to for the pyramid blocks for the beacon to sit on. Oops. Oh, the jump effect drives me nuts. So I'm thinking about or actively planning something else to help make that easier. Let me take care of some of this, and then we'll go take a look at that. All right, so let's dump off some stuff here, and let me go show you the other project. Splash potion, blah, blah, blah. I need to set up a brewing stand here, and probably also a furnace, and let's see here, more food. My water, ender pearls. Oh, I'm sorry. I got confused. I'm not on the snapshot tour. I don't need ender pearls that badly. That I need to actually aggravate endermen in the overworld. Okay. Okay. So I'm going to stash this in here because honestly, I don't need to make the beacon out of it, and we still got a good network ping, so let's get out of here. Let's see if I actually get out of the portal. Nice. Okay. Yeah, one thing I noticed, if there's any network activity that causes any kind of latency, getting through portals is a monstrous pain in the butt. It's a problem. And they tried to fix it by putting you out next to the portal, but that was causing problems, so they changed it back, and it's kind of annoying. Okay. Hey, guys. Whoa. Out of the portal, come on. See, that kind of thing's happened. It does the whole rubber banding thing. See, I'm down one level on the ping now. It's very annoying. Okay. Get out here. Instead of going down here, out to the XP farm and the Enderman farm, go up here. See, I got my beacon, and this isn't really where I wanted to show you, but we'll show you what I'm doing here. It's kind of appropriate. Single four level beacon, and coming out here and using it to just mine all this obsidian, because obsidian takes so long to mine. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna mine out a layer here, but you don't need to watch it because it takes a while. So hang on a second and I'll bring you out to where I was actually intending to show you. Is when I jump through the portal there back to the overworld, I'm gonna end up back at the wither hole, since that's the last bed I slept in. So I'm gonna have to go back into the nether and go where I want to go. So hang on a sec. Okay, we're back in the nether successfully. It was a little bit painful because we are down a little bit on our pings, but it's very annoying. All right, so we're gonna go up here to the gold farm seen this before. So nothing super new up there, but I'm working on something that I think will be interesting. So hang on a sec. All right, so here's our gold farm. This is new. Hello, look at me. Yeah, so here's the thing. I want to build another gold farm tower over there, and maybe a third over there. But this thing was expensive. Each layer required a couple stacks of note blocks. And note blocks are relatively easy to make, but they just take a lot of wood. So I'm gonna make a tree farm here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 8, 4. Oh, I didn't really want to do it that way. Okay, so it's just gonna take a ton of hoppers. So I've got a chest here, and I've got a bunch of hoppers that I'm going to lay out in a grid, and I'm going to plant trees here in the nether and bone meal them until they grow. Oops. And I figure this is going to be like 140 hoppers. It's a little bit ridiculous. Hey, don't do that. But I want to cover the area that the branches will grow. So that this is the center point here. So So the tree will go here. We want to go out 2, 3, 4, 5. I think this will catch all the falling wood and saplings. That's the plan. I'm gonna have to half slab everything because we don't want ghast spawning on top of this thing. Oops. Which they will do. And hopefully that's... Is that gonna be enough? So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hopefully I have enough hoppers here. I had to go spend some time at the iron farm to get the iron to make these hoppers because I'm using iron everywhere on my beacons because the iron farm is a little bit more productive just in sheer volume than the gold farm because it takes 9 gold nuggets to make a gold ingot. Takes 81 of them to make a gold block, and when you need 2.5 stacks of gold blocks to make a full beacon setup, it takes a while. Woohoo, we have some left over. Let's go get the slabs so we can keep the ghasts from spawning. So I have slabs here, and I'm going to make more because we're going to need a lot of slabs for this. Pop, there we go. All right, slab away. So if I half slab over the whole thing, oops, then no gas will be able to spawn. Oops. And then, or pigmen, or magma cubes, anything that can spawn. It's always disconcerting listening to the gas, but the gas that we're hearing is down below us in the nether, sort of proper. Whew. So these hoppers will be able to pick up the droppings through the half slabs. Just the same way we're doing it right here. As the pigmen fall to their death. Ooh, they drop zombie flesh and stuff. Little half slab, here's a step. And, okay. So, the next step is to get... I have some spruce saplings and I have some dirt. And I have bones. Some of this stuff can just go in here because I don't need it. And then I'm going to just start collecting stuff because we need, we need stuff here. So this isn't going to be super organized just yet. I need some of these and, these can go up. All right, so now the trick here is putting some dirt in the correct place. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pop, pop. Okay, and then I want to plant saplings. And then I want to take bone meal to it. Look at that tree. And everything should fall down and I should have a little bit of margin. So we are going to have to take a half slab here. It's my only. I'm gonna have to repair this pick a little bit. Oops. So these guys, wrong tool. So these guys, I like using spruce for this. The wood, the type of wood doesn't matter. I'm going to be making note blocks. And for note blocks, you just need planks and redstone. And the reason I'm using note blocks is because I'm using pistons with slime blocks, sticky pistons with slime blocks. And, oops. And the slime blocks, if I need something that the slime blocks can't push for the foundation, for the framework. And slime blocks cannot push no blocks. So it's convenient. We could also use furnaces, but it's going to be difficult enough for me to get all the appropriate, all the cobblestone I need for the pistons, let alone for that many furnaces. So this is actually cheaper than furnaces. So now those leaves up there will decay, and I can put. So the idea here was, because I want to. I was going to slab over this temporarily, but you know what? Yeah, just to be, no, you know, well, I don't have any, we'll slab over temporarily. That was my idea. So now, oh look, the stuff that dropped. I already have one sapling. So the idea is that when I get enough saplings, as these leaves decay, they will drop all this stuff and they will get picked up and funneled into here. That's the idea. Except, of course, the stuff that ends up on top of the dirt blocks. They're the slabbed dirt blocks. So my thought was, since I have plenty of saplings, I could just replant this. I have saplings in here. I have a whole stack of them. I like the spruce because you plant them in the 2x2 configuration like that, and they grow straight up with no branches. It makes them very easy to harvest the wood. So that got me a stack and a little bit, a stack and a quarter basically of spruce logs. And I have to go get some redstone. But the nice thing is that with two stacks of spruce wood, we'll make a stack of note blocks. So I can come up, and as long as I'm okay on saplings, I can just keep replanting and regrowing. And spruce trees are pretty generous with their saplings, so you don't really need to worry too much. So they're not like jungle trees, which are horrible. They don't, they barely give you, on average, they barely give you enough saplings to grow another one. And so, oh, that guy's even bigger. Oh, look at that. He's a huge one. Awesome. So anyway, so this is my nether tree farm. And we will, let's see, I've got a surplus of saplings already. So, no, this can go on there. You can go there. Anyway, you see how that works. I don't need to belabor the point, but that's how we're going to be making all the note blocks. I don't have to go back into the overworld and harvest my spruce trees there. I may want to set up more than one of these, although it gets expensive with all the hoppers. So anyway, I think that'll be it. Thank you for watching, and I will be back with more from the Minecraft LAN Party server. I'm certainly not done here. I have taken a little bit of time, but oh, hello. I've been playing on the Snapshot Tour and playing around with the snapshot, but I haven't lost interest here. There's still plenty to do. Instead, I have an idea for the blaze spawner. And I need gold, so if I build one or two more of these towers over there and over there, so from the same AFK spot, all three of them are active. I mean, there's plenty of space here. May as well. It's just going to take resources. The nether brick slabs. I've got plenty of nether brick downstairs. And I'll need another thing of hoppers here, but it should be good. And then instead of going into a chest here, my idea is that all three of them will pipe through hopper chains into a sorting system. And instead of racks like this, we'll make a proper sorting system that will put all the rotten flesh into one set of storage, because honestly, I don't know, these are all full, and this pile is half full, a little more than half full, so we don't need, I don't know, don't do enough villager trading to need this much zombie flesh, but I don't feel like throwing it out, which is probably silly on my part, but hey. Seem to get the farm to activate here a bit. And check to make sure that this tree is not enough for gas to spawn on. Hopefully they cannot spawn on leaves. That would be bad if they could. It would mean I can't really leave a tree in place here, but I don't know, we'll see. Time will tell. I also need to count the layers here so I can actually estimate how many resources we need. Because I have notes, but it's on a layer-by-layer basis, and I forget how many layers of this there are. And I want to change the top, because right now it's designed to try and prevent stuff from spawning, but it doesn't work. I left too much space, and I may as well put in... some pistons and you can't even see the tree. Some pistons and some slime blocks to push the guys that spawn up on this very top layer, push them off. I mean, they walk off eventually, but I don't know. Seems like we could improve the situation. So, anyway, that's like the big project that I have planned. And I'll show you updates as we move forward. Hey, little guy. Yeah, see? They're going now. Woohoo. Ooh. All right. Well, again, thank you for watching. I keep aborting my outros. Thanks for watching. This is Theron. This is the Minecraft LAN Party. And I'll see you next time.